I'm Neha Ahuja. I'm a GP and medical educator in the Undergraduate Primary Care Education Unit at Imperial College London. In this video, we'll discuss what sustainable healthcare means and how you, as GP tutors, can support your students to learn more about sustainable healthcare, which is now a key part of the medical curriculum. Our health is intrinsically linked to the health of the planet. Climate change is already affecting our health and will impact our ability to deliver healthcare in the future. The delivery of healthcare itself contributes towards environmental impacts. So there's an urgent need for our students to understand this relationship between us and our environment and learn how to practice medicine in a way that meets the healthcare needs of today without compromising the health of future generations. This is sustainable healthcare. It involves minimizing the environmental impact of healthcare activities, practicing in a socially equitable way, and managing healthcare resources efficiently. Opportunities to practice sustainable healthcare are all around us, from preventative healthcare, health promotion, and person-centered care, to supporting self-care, streamlining our systems, and finding ways to lower our carbon footprint.
So could you tell me a bit more about the different types of inhalers that are available?
Sure, so there's two main types of inhalers.
Let's now hear some thoughts from medical student Holly Myers and GP tutor Dr. Tamsin Ellis.
As a GP tutor, I think we're really well placed to help students understand and learn about the environment and sustainable healthcare. I think we can also inspire students to make sustainable changes. So at our practice, we found a few ways to do that successfully. The first thing that we noticed is telling stories, and that's telling your own story, telling student stories, how that's connected to the environment and what's happening to our planet. I've noticed as a GP that I've seen the impacts of the environment on my patients. So that might be in those extreme weather events, in the hotter summers when you see people having issues with their kidneys or more falls, cardiovascular disease, and also in the winter months, particularly in deprived areas where people can't afford to heat their homes and having issues with fuel poverty and the health outcomes of that. The second thing that we've noticed is to make it relevant for students. We don't want this to be an add-on or an additional thing for students to learn about. So we found success with making it part of the community action projects and quality improvement that students have to do at practices. And that really helps them embed the changes into their curriculum and what they're learning. The third thing that we've noticed works well is to secure those win-wins, to think about what's happening and how that impacts on the patients, the practice pocket, and the planet. We know that making sustainable changes can often save practices money and help students understand those wider parts of the practice workings, but also the co-benefits for patients. So that's things like thinking about nutritious diets, active travel, connection to nature, all these things that make things better for the patients and better for the planet.
As a student, learning about sustainable healthcare in my GP placement has inspired me to think really differently. I've realised that it's not just about treating the patient that's in front of me, but also thinking about how my actions impact things such as public health, resource allocation, and impact the environment as a whole. I can now see how relevant it is in patient care, but also my medical school projects. I now understand much more about how we can best use resources to reduce the carbon footprint of treatments. For example, on placement, I've noticed how when reviewing a patient's medication and deprescribing where appropriate, it's not only good for the patient, but it also reduces the unnecessary use of resources and therefore reduces the carbon footprint of that patient's treatment. Thinking about the bigger picture has changed how I approach having conversations with patients. I now take the time to fully explore the social context behind the patients I meet and explore what truly matters to them.
Thanks to Dr. Tamsin Ellis and our student Holly for their insights. We hope this video has given you some ideas about how to support students to learn more about sustainable healthcare in practice. There are lots of resources available for GP tutors, and these are included in the description below. If you have any questions or comments, please get in touch with us through the faculty development team. Thank you very much for watching and for your ongoing support for our medical students.